A 28-year-old Paul Lambert reaches out to the National Union of Seafarers.
What I wanted to ask you about was actually Derbyshire.
I think you should take a look at this.
Lambert learns a shocking number of bulk carriers have been sinking.
On average, one bulk carrier sank every 6 to 7 weeks with total loss of life. The era of the Coffin ships, that's how we classed it.
The Derbyshire is one of six sister ships designed with steel beams along the length of their hulls to add strength. But during construction, the girders are joined at frame number 65, creating a potential weak point. Investigators guide a remote camera vehicle 2.5 miles below the surface of the Pacific Ocean. The ROV has captured thousands of high-definition photographs. Investigators scrutinize them, searching for any sign of a fracture that occurred before the ship sank, in particular, around the known structural flaw at frame 65.
We definitely had to find evidence whether the rupturing of all the metal parts around bulkhead 65 was brittle or ductile. Ductile means that it took place slowly. Brittle means that the fragmentation took place rapidly.
But it's a dead end. Frame 65 shows unmistakable signs of the same explosive phenomenon.
It wasn't frame 65. This happened when she was already going down.
The cause they had hoped to prove, a weakness in her construction, is not the reason the Derbyshire sank.
We evidence that all these empty compartments aft of the bulkhead 65 had been imploded, exploded when the ship was sinking. So that means that there was no cracking on bulkhead 65.
If it wasn't frame 65, something else must have triggered the disaster.
We're losing her!
We're gonna lose her!